everyone, if you do not know who I am, my name is Paradoxical Intention, but y'all can call me Paradoxy. And welcome back to Psychonauts! Last time we started off the game, we got to introduce to a Spring Rock Psychic Summer Camp, and now we're going through basic braining. We're going into the mind of Coach Oleander, one of the teachers at Whispering Rock Psychic Summer Camp. And now we've come across this little game. We have to hit this button and then hit some stuff. I know, dude. I know. Thank you. These two are cheerleader types, I guess.
Shut up, shut up, shut up! We'll never give up on you, Raz!
Yeah! Yay! 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 Yay, Raz! Alright.
You score enough points on this course, kid, and I'll give you a reward.
Ooh, rewards are cool. Target, of course! We gotta hit the bad guys, but we cannot hit the babies. This pretty much just gives you some very basic combat training in the game. Later on, we're actually going to learn how to shoot some psi bullets, which will be really fun. But this is just your basic attack. And while the combat in this game is a teeny bit difficult sometimes, like, shit, I keep missing. There we go. Okay. The combat in this game can be a little hard to master at first. Once you get the hang of it, it's not that hard. Woo! 12 seconds to spare! Aww. I actually kind of liked them. I guess Raz didn't that much. Ooh, another Svolt. This is another thing I'd like to see as a plushie, because they're just so little and so adorable. And they look so cuddly. A lot of the things in this game look very cuddly. Yeah, Coach Oleander was just explaining what vaults are. Essentially, when you get a vault, you get like a little thing. I'll show you in a second, since I can hit this thing. Come here, you. Hiya! So pretty much, this is just like a reel of memories or of thoughts in a person's head. And as you can see, Coach Oleander exaggerates quite a bit. You know, with the whole long legs, you know, Army, Navy, Air Force stuff, so... I'm sure it is one of your favorites. Up, oh, yeah. Let's get moving. It says, gotta hit this, then move to the next one before we get shot. There's also another hat box tag. Oh, mental health. Maintaining your mental health is important because if you run out, you'll not be able to maintain your astral projection in this mine, and you'll be kicked back into the real world. Oh, little bunnies, what are you doing? Yay! Look how happy he is! He just... He looks like he's gonna cry some more.
Run, bunny!
Yeah, run, bunny! No, not the bunnies! Ow! Yeah, finally a power down. Let's get moving! Come on, come on. Up, up, up. Up the ladder. Duffel bag tag. You again! Does Classic Zilch ever involve taking a shower, maybe? Because you look kind of nasty. Like, seriously, brush your teeth, go take a shower, please. You're... The whole hair and mouth thing is freaking me out. Canteen, grenade, big scary dude. Woohoo! Some more figments. Yeah, because more figments you get, the faster we lever off. Yeah, of course Raz knows. Raz knows he's in the freaking circus. Come on. Why won't it let me... It's not letting me jump. There we go. Yeah, we need to go this way. Change direction. Gotta watch out for the fire. Fire bad. There we go. Ooh, more figments. Duffel bag! I will never get tired of these sweet little things being happy. Look at that. Look at that smile. I know some of you are probably going, stop it. No, I will not. Ooh, more fire. There we go. Cracked wall, smack that open.
Hold it right there, boy. That's a mental cobweb. You can collect them with a specialized piece of equipment once you get checked out on.
Yeah.
Just steer clear of them.
We can come back in here later and get that stuff, but for now that requires a cobweb duster that we don't have. So you have to get it from the store, and I don't remember how much they cost. I think it's like really a lot of money, though. Or arrowheads, as it were. See? That's one thing I really like about the game is that they explain why Raz is so. I say that as I die, but Raz is really good at jumping from stuff and doing all this because he was in the circus, so it makes sense for him to be able to do all these things. Whereas a lot of other characters in other games, it wouldn't make sense for them to be able to jump up and down and do the tightrope walk and all of that based on their backstory. So props to the writers for making that one make sense.
It's game day, kid.
No kidding. I'm playing a game right now, sir. I know, stop breaking the fourth wall. Speaking of breaking walls.
As you can see, the trapeze is very difficult. Most cadets can't handle it. You might just want to stay away from it.
I was raised on this shit!
Ribbon at the end of camp.
Participation ribbon? Excuse me, participation ribbon? I'll show you participation ribbon.
It's game day, kid!
Yeah, I'm missing figments. Not that I really care. Nice, neat little swing there at the end. Nice little flip.
It's game day, kid. Hey, kid.
Shit. Jumped a little too soon, and that's always a pain in the ass. At least they have like kind of like a checkpoint system going. So that way, you know, if you mess up, and you will mess up, you can just hop right back to where you were. Little to no fuss. Not everything about the gameplay is perfect. Like, as I said before, the combat can be kind of sticky, but it's not that bad, actually.
Onward and upward, soldier.
Like I said, this is one of those handling issues I mentioned in the first videos. Sometimes it's a little difficult to just get things done properly in this game. But for the most part, it's still really fun, and the gameplay issues aren't really enough to make you stop playing. You know, that law of diminishing returns doesn't apply. I missed that one. Yeah!
Mentalis Uberalis!
End of the line, sucker!
Get out of my way! Yeah, you show him, Raz. You show him. Oh, there's another checkpoint. We can teleport back and forth to different parts of the game. Or different parts of the level, excuse me.
The old rolling tunnel of crazy lords, bitch. An old one, but a hard one. What you gotta do is... who we kidding?
Yes, we will. To be honest, it's not really that hard. The thing is with this game is that the difficulty level isn't that hard at first. Near the end of the game, though, it starts to really ramp up really hard. The last level is, it's going to take me a while to finish it. Because I just, if you've played this game before, you know exactly what I'm talking about when I say, like, the last level is one of the hardest, if not the hardest, in the entire game. And that's a good thing. It's like difficult, but it's like a good kind of difficult that makes you go, you know what, I'm gonna stick this through and I'm gonna beat it. It's not like E.T. for the Atari kind of hard, where it's just like you just give up because it's like it's not worth it. No, beating this game is totally 100% worth it. Hey, this is the end. Okay. So now where are we? Well, nobody over there, so I think this... Are those bunnies? Those are bunnies. I never noticed that before. Bunnies and carrots.
Hold it right there, son! Now just what in the Sam Hill do you think you're doing in there?
I was just looking for a way out.
Oh. Sorry about that. Didn't think you'd get to the end so fast. Dang, I didn't think you'd get to the end at all. You surprised me out there, kid. Here, you've earned this. Your first Psychonaut Merit Badge.
Woo! Merit Badges. Yeah, Merit Badges are very important because they give us access to new powers, and they pretty much rank us up to the point where we could be considered a Psychonaut. You notice there's like lots of spaces on the back of Raz's backpack, and we have to get all of those badges before we can be considered a Psychonaut. And we will get all those badges before the game is out.
But I'm always glad to see a soldier come back from the field alive. Now, if you'll excuse me, I gotta go back in. I left some good men back there.
Creepy. I think one of his eyes is actually fake. You could, it just, like, the way it looks, either it's, like, dead and it can't see anything, or it's just fake and it doesn't move. It's still freaky. Because you notice, like, one eye rolled up in the back of his head. Bobby Zilch can kiss the fattest part of my ass.
Yourself, goggle-licious. What's that, hair boy? You want a piece of me?
Hey, brainiacs, settle down.
Why? You worried I'm gonna hurt your boyfriend?
No. Because Sasha 9 is standing right behind you.
Your performance, young cadet, was outstanding. I'd like you to report to my lab for some advanced training.
Ooh! Raz's spaz is gonna be in a special class! Benny, remind me to give him a special beating later, okay?
These tests are unauthorized, though, so I can't actually ask you to come. But if you happen to drop in, well, what can I do? Let me just give you this.
A button?
Remember, your talent will always set you apart, Rasputin. Sometimes isolation is a good thing. It can lead to important discoveries.
He's kind of a show-off, isn't he?
Wait! I don't even know what your lab is! Is this some kind of test?
Obviously. Can't just...
Sometimes isolation is a good thing. It can lead to important discoveries.
And now I'm hearing things. Great.
I'm surprised you can hear anything with that hood.
You know where this button is from, Coach?
Hey, you stole a button from the geodesic psycho-isolation chamber!
No, I didn't. I... Bobby Zilch gave it to me.
Should have known. Spends more time in the cooler than in school. Reminds me of myself when I was his age. Well, go put it back.
Okay.
Yes, sir. Hey, Coach, where is the G?
Don't you know how to use your map?
Right. Yes, sorry.
Yeah. I already know where it is, so we don't need to check the map. But if we ever need to, you can always just access it in your journal.
No passing.
But I need to get to Sasha 9's secret lab.
Maybe you should have thought of that before.
I did think of that before. That's why I'm here now.
Makes sense.
Exactly. Now you gotta pay the toll.
Toll.
One arrowhead. Pay up.
I found this thing. Is that what you're talking about?
Yep. That's an arrowhead.
How'd they get here?
Frankie, built on an Indian burial ground, and...
Oh my gosh! Indians buried their dead here?
Ew! I hope not. No, stupid. They buried their arrowheads here.
They're hidden underground, but they let out a little gas once in a while.
Just like Coach Oleander.
So if you see any of that stuff, just pull them right out.
Yeah,
like
we...
truffles.
Anyway,
truffles.
Let me have one of yours.
Fine, just take it. That's the only way we're going to get across the camp. But anyways, if we see some purple gas, we should be able to pull up an arrowhead. And, you know, it's easy enough to find them. You can buy things like the Psycores and the Dream Fluffs and all kinds of stuff. That really help you out.
There you. Come here, you. Can't do the scavenger hunt without a list. Report back to me when you have enough items for your first promotion. Now get!
Yeah, and this is kind of a side thing. We don't have to do it, but I most likely will, because some people will ask
so
for it. It will find them all around camp. Some of them are really easy to get to. Some of them are... some of them are almost impossible to get.
You, new boy. Seen bear lurking in woods?
Nope.
Positive. Giant, hairless bear?
Nope.
In Russia, bears much smaller. Also more hair. Less lurking. Always eager to wrestle. This one, hide and run.
I'll let you know if I see anything.
Cannot lurk forever.
That kid's a badass. I like you. Wrestle bears. You leave Dogen alone, squirrel. Because we need to go this way, because that's the symbol for the isolation chambers. Although, I think first we should check out the shop. Because they might have something we could use. Also, there's a card. Oh, and there's our little cheerleader buddies.
Hey, it's the king of the obstacle course!
Damn right.
Hey, Les! You're awesome! You must be a psychonaut by now!
No.
Yeah, or even a double psychonaut!
Oh no, not yet. But soon. Wow, those two are so nice.
Aren't they though? Yeah, everybody in this camp has their own little quirks and stuff, and these two are either a little suicidal or murderous. I can never figure out which one. No, get back up there, Raz. I'm pretty sure they're just suicidal, like manic depressive or something like that. Scary. But, you know, they got their problems, and... I guess maybe they just need someone to talk to. I mean, Lily!
Hey, Lily. Do you know where Sasha 9's secret lab is?
Secret? It's printed on your map. Duh.
Oh, I knew that. I was just curious if you knew where Sasha 9's lab was. Because I do.
She's not buying it, dude. So, okay. So the camp store is in the cafeteria. I like Sasha encouraging kids to read. Mia Vardello encouraging kids to read. I don't know who that is, though. Or that. Punching him in the nuts, Jesus. Frog. I guess those guys must be like other psychonauts, maybe? Interesting enough.
Hey, you guys are good.
Thanks, man. Hey, do you have a lighter? Because if you lit it and held it up right now, that would be rad.
And completely insensitive to me and my issues.
Yeah, she's a pyrokinesis kind of person.
I forgot about the whole fire bad thing for a moment.
Hey, why are you stopping?
Oh, I thought you stopped.
No, 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 no. Let's go.
Drum solo!
Woo! You heard the man.
Sorry, my bad.
Not to worry, my bro. Let's just pick it up from the part where I do that thing.
so nice to each other.
I told you the burgers ain't ready.
No, you didn't.
The coals ain't hot. They're not gonna be done for a while. Maybe a week.
A week?
They're back ordered. I'm the only one back here. These things take time.
Damn, waiting for a whole week to eat a burger.
Oh, well, why didn't you say so? So, what do you want? Oh, that's my last cobweb duster.
Yes, cobweb duster. Costs 20 arrow, 800 arrowheads, and we have to be level 20. That's 250. We need to be 30. 15, 10. Okay, we can get nothing. Nutritious and cheap. My left foot. Yeah, so pretty much that's the camp store. We can buy things like Dream Fluffs, which are like little like health potions, essentially. Then there's like a bunch of tools we'll need later on that we can't get right now because, you know, we're not high enough level and they're really expensive. That's back to camp. So we need to go this way past the bridge. Over there's the parking lot, which I don't think it's a place of importance at the moment. It could be later. Oh, sweet.
Would you like to go back to your private sanctuary now, Agent Krella? Or somewhere else?
Sanctuary.
Let's go to Ford's. I mean, my sanctuary.
Yes, noble Psycho Master.
Bouncy, bouncy. So yeah, once we discover locations, we can use the underground rocket transportation system to get there easier, so we don't have to do all the walking. Look at that.
It's an honor to finally meet you in person, sir. I thought I recognized you in my dream, but I couldn't be sure. Now that I see you in your element, there's no doubt. You're Ford Kruller, the greatest leader the Psychonauts ever had.
Well, you shouldn't believe everything you read in True Psychic Tales magazine.
Yeah, what are you doing here at Whispering Rock?
What are you doing here at Whispering Rock?
This training facility is built right smack on top of the largest titanium deposit known to man. It runs under this whole valley and makes this a very critical area for the Psychonauts. So I'm here to look after it and to make sure you little spoon benders don't kill each other.
Yeah, Bobby Zilch had his way.
What's titanium?
Titanium is a very rare psychoreactive mineral that crashed here on a meteorite hundreds of years ago. It responds to psychic waves, focuses them, amplifies them. It can make psychics more psychic, but it can also make unstable people more unstable. Not everyone can handle that much activity in that part of their brain. It can drive them completely out of their gourd.
Makes sense.
Gives this valley an interesting history.
I imagine. Sayu Ricking leaves.
Sayu Ricking leaves. Was that a disguise?
Yes. Well, God, I have many disguises. Keep an eye on you kids wherever you go.
Yeah, that didn't sound very convincing.
I may pretend not to recognize you. Don't blow my cover, okay?
Say no more. Your secret identity is safe with me.
Yeah. What mission are you on?
So, what mission are you on down here?
Well, from here I can monitor world events, look for signs of psychic terrorism, ripples in the astral plane.
And then fly out and save the day, right? You've got a jet hidden here somewhere, I'll bet.
Well, you know, these days I'm really just more of a dispatcher. I spot the trouble and send out a younger agent, like Mia or Sasha. Or maybe you someday.
That'd be awesome. Equipment!
What does all this equipment do?
Well, up here, it's all intel. Down that hallway is the observation room. No tests going on in there right now. Maybe later. And beneath us, I have special machines for rebuilding psi challenge markers and detangling mental cobwebs. You should go familiarize yourself with those. They'll come in pretty handy for you.
Yeah, they will.
I'd better go.
Let's work.
Lots of work to do.
Good luck, Rasputin.
Thanks. I'll need it.
No kidding.
Don't worry. I'll be right here with you. Inside your head.
Head?
Yep. I want to keep my eye on you, son, so... I'm going to be a psychic stowaway inside your noggin. If you ever want to make me appear, you can do it with this special device.
Bacon?
smell that stuff and I can't help it. I drop everything and come running.
Okay. Do you have like a little baggie or something I can put this in?
You get a move on or I'll eat that right here.
I understand, my man. I love bacon too. Alright, let's finally get over to Sasha's lab. We've dicked around enough. That's at the main lodge.
Oh, bring me back a burger this time, will you?
I love that. Like, every little character in this game has their own personality and stuff. Even the computer that takes you back and forth to different areas of the camp. Alright, so let's go find our good friend, Sasha 9. He's gotta be around here somewhere. There it is. That's where we need to go. Okay, so the main lodge is that way, the lake is over that way, but this is to the GPC.
Hey, you're that new kid, ain't you? Well, I'm doing some advanced training right now, as a matter of fact, so I don't think new kid is really a name that you want to get too used to saying.
No kidding.
Hold on there. You're not doing Sasha 9's advanced training that he does in a secret underground lab, are you? Hidden deep within the iron walls of the GPC where no one can hear you screaming?
Why, yes, I am. Sakes alive.
Well, nice knowing you.
I've heard rumors about Sasha and his experiments. Ew.
Nice. You should write greeting cards.
There was some sort of shadowy being out there. Lurking. Watching.
I know of only one creature who fits that description. It likes to hide in dark places, silently watching unsuspecting children from a distance.
Really? Who?
You, tree sitter!
I love Lily. She's delightfully sarcastic. Nope, can't get up there. That's okay, though. Arrowhead.
I saw Nils peeking into a hole in the girl's cabin.
I'm hiding.
I'm hiding.
Oh, Nils. When will you peek into a hole in my heart? Because you just see yourself staring back.
Uh-huh. What?
I mean, you'd see my new boyfriend James staring back. And he'd be furious at Nils.
Who's Nils?
Exactly! Anyway, there wouldn't even be a hole because James fills my heart till sometimes I think it's gonna explode.
One time, I made someone's head explode.
Yeah, you made a bunch of squirrels explode. You really freaked me out, but you're still my favorite, dude. Oh no, it's that other kid. What are you doing?
Hey, who is that?
Raz, is that you? It's me, Maloof.
Hang on, buddy. Give me a sec to pop this tin can.
Poor kid.
Thanks. I thought I was gonna have to eat my own arm.
Jesus, that's dark.
What is this thing?
It's a GPC, a geodesic psycho-isolation chamber.
Oh man, cool.
Cool? Do you have any idea what this does?
Something cool?
No. It's a 6-sensory deprivation chamber.
Ooh.
A hermetically sealed metaphysical hotbox. It's solitary confinement for psychics.
Nasty. And the coach locked you inside it?
Nah, the staff hasn't put any kids in the GPC since the 50s. Bobby threw me in here.
Figures.
Boolean warfare complex should assault own size or larger only. Why even cooler? Perhaps notice gigantic bear with skin where hair should be?
I didn't see anything in there. That's the whole point.
Just so. Empty now. Good luck, small ones.
Hey, wait!
Yeah, no, hang out with that dude, Maloof.
On sale now in the main store, we have a special on dream fluffs. You hear me? Dream quick boost of mental health.
Well, at least we know Sasha 9's lab is in here.
Looks like one.
Yeah, we know. Okay. Which one was it? One? One. Okay. And then use the button on that. Pretty high tech considering. Alright, just before we jump in there, I think we're going to end the episode here. So, with that being said, have fun, good game, and bye-nee!